The Litchi software is a tool for controlling the DJI Phantom and Inspire aircraft. It allows you to set locations and have the aircraft fly missions that are smooth and accurate. The flight can be autonomous to the level the pilot wants. You can take full control of the aircraft with a flip of the switch on your controller. In this tutorial, I will be setting up a mission to fly waypoints and points of interest. I will also be setting actions at some waypoints which automate the camera and the action of the aircraft. I will then fly the mission. To simplify narration, I will often use P and a number for a point of interest and W and a number for a waypoint. I will be using my iPad Air 2 for entering information to the Litchi mission. The iPad is connected to my PC with Air Server. The Air server is being recorded with Lightcam HD. This seems overly complex, but it allows me to use the PC cursor to point out things on the screen at the same time I am entering mission information, and allows viewing things during entry that don't appear when just recording the iPad actions with Litchi or Air server. Don't be confused by the PC cursor. It is not part of the Litchi software, nor part of the iPad system. When you see the yellow splash at the cursor, I'm just clicking the mouse to emphasize the location and to indicate where I will tap the screen. Our mission is to fly near five buildings at the Historical Museum at Fort Missoula. I'll zoom out so we can easily see the five buildings we want to visit. I will set points of interest at each of these buildings. 1. NCO Quarters. 2. Homestead Cabin. 3. Grant Creek Schoolhouse. 4. St. Michael's Church. 5. Drummond Train Depot. To set a point of interest, select the Point of Interest tool by tapping on it. Then touch the map where you want the point of interest inserted. Once you insert a point of interest, you can tap and hold to move it around. Notice that this point of interest has been set at an altitude of 3 feet. You can tap on the point of interest and adjust the altitude as desired. Either use the slider or tap on the minus or plus signs. I'll set the altitude of this point of interest at about 10 feet. Now I'll enter the other 4 points of interest and I'll leave them at the default altitude. Next, I want to lay out the mission route by entering waypoints. I need to turn off the Point of Interest tool by tapping it again. However, if you forget to turn it off and happen to add another point of interest, you can tap on the point of interest and tap the minus sign in the upper left corner to remove it. Since I am in the waypoint mode, entering waypoints is the default when you tap on the map. I will start the flight from the path on the loop near the center of the map. Tapping the map inserts W1. Notice that the point of the aircraft points to P2. I want to start the aircraft pointing to P1. To do so, I tap on the waypoint and set the POI to P1. And then close the editing box by tapping X. Now I'll enter several more waypoints to make the rest of the mission. I'm happy with the mission so far, so I'll save this mission. I can then retrieve it for further editing at any time. We can move waypoints around like we did points of interest by tapping and holding. I'm going to move W1 a little so we are sure to avoid the large tree when moving from W1 to W2. Also notice that all the waypoints defaulted to an altitude of 98 feet. We can adjust the altitude by tapping on the waypoint and using the altitude slider or minus and plus buttons to change the altitude of the waypoint. I'll set the altitude of W1 to about 50 feet by tapping the minus sign. The altitude now for W1 is 52 feet. I want the aircraft to remain pointing at P1 while flying from W1 to W2. Notice that at W2, the aircraft is currently pointing at P2. The direction of the aircraft when entering waypoints in the focus POI mode is to point at the nearest point of interest. I'm going to change the P2 for W2 to P1 by tapping on W2 and selecting P1. If we look at W3, it is pointing at P2, which is fine for this mission. W4 and W5 are also pointing in a good direction at P4. However, I would like the altitude along the open area to be about 60 feet rather than 98 feet, so I'm going to change the altitude of both W4 and W5 to about 60 feet by tapping each and setting the altitude, and verify the settings are correct. If we look at W6, we see that it is pointing at P2. I would prefer that it point at P3 from an altitude of about 70 feet. I'll change those by tapping on W6 and adjusting the P and altitude. Now we have the aircraft pointing at P3 from an altitude of 72 feet. When we look at the remaining waypoints, W7 and W8 are pointing at P5, which is what we want. We also want the altitude at the default 98. The only remaining waypoint is W9, and it is pointing back at P1, but we would like it to point to P2 from an altitude of 72 feet. So I'll change W9 and then save the changes. I would also like to do some things at the waypoints other than just fly by. At W6, I would like a photo of the school. At W7, I would like a photo of the train depot. To do these things, we need to add actions to the waypoints. To get a photo at W6, I tap on W6 and scroll to the action area. I tap the plus sign to add an action. Since I had already started recording at W1, I tap on the stop recording action. I again tap on the plus sign to add another action and tap on take photo to add the action. Now when the aircraft reaches W6, it will stop recording video and take a photo. However, we want to restart recording, so we need to add the start recording action. If we added an incorrect action or changed our minds about an action we added, we can delete an action by tapping and sliding to the left and tapping delete. I'll add the same actions at W7. Sometimes you want the recording to run in a stationary place for a few seconds, rather than just flying by. At W8, I'll add an action that causes the aircraft to stay at that location for 4 seconds. If we happen to miss entering a waypoint that we wanted, we can't just tap in between two waypoints because new waypoints are added past the last waypoint in the mission. To get a waypoint between two others, tap on the lower numbered waypoint and notice you have a minus and plus sign in the upper left corner of the editing box. By tapping on the plus sign, you can add a waypoint between the current and next waypoints. Let's do that between W3 and W4. Notice that the higher numbered waypoints have been renumbered, so we now have 10 waypoints instead of 9. I'll remove the waypoint we just added. Now we're back to 9 waypoints. There are many other things you can do with waypoints, but we'll cover more in part 2. For now, let's save the mission again. Next, we'll fly the mission and see what it looks like.